In this video, we're going to talk about sculpting brushes in Forger. There are several of them, and each one of them has a different behavior. Each brush has generally two different modes, and a lot of parameters that can be tweaked. The generic mode is run when the brush is used. The alternate mode will be run when the alternate shortcut is pressed. Generally, this mode tends to mean the opposite method of the default. For instance, push and pull, inflate, deflate, etc. In this video, we will only talk about the basic parameters that are found on most brushes. Those parameters are accessible from the tool menu. At the top of the tool menu, we have a preview of the brush. This preview will automatically refresh when we adjust parameters that affect the stroke behavior. We can also use this preview to try out our brushes before we use them on the mesh. We can adjust the size and strength of the brushes. We can choose whether we want pressure to affect the brush size and/or the strength. The spacing parameter represents the distance between each dab of the brush stroke. The higher it is, the more distance between each dab. We can see the representation of this in the preview. The falloff curve allows modifying how the brush behaves depending on the distance from the center of the brush. We can also tweak it and see the updated preview to see how it may affect the brush behavior. Then there are the stroke parameters that affect the entire brush stroke. There is the stroke type, which allows us to choose between dabbing and line. Dabbing is the fastest mode, creating dots where possible, whereas line, although a bit slower, will automatically fill in the gaps when needed, creating smoother strokes. Each brush has a sensible default. Then there is the smooth stroke parameter, which can only be tweaked when the stroke type is set to line. This allows us to do very smooth strokes and avoids any unwanted jittery behavior. This parameter uses the smooth stroke distance value to decide how many screen pixels to delay the brush actions by. Then there is the tip shape section, which affects how the tip of the brush will behave. In order to look at this, we will need to set a brush tip image. And for that, we will need to open the stamp picker found just under the active tool icon. As you can see, there are some stamps already, but we can add our custom ones by simply dragging and dropping them from Safari or other apps. Or adding them to a folder named stamps inside the Forger directory in the Files app. All stamps must be square in size, or they will be listed as invalid and thus won't be usable. We're going to select a brush tip by tapping on it. Remember that we can reset the brush tip image to a no image stamp by tapping on the first blank stamp. As you can see, when a brush tip is set, the preview updates to reflect this change. The tip angle represents the default angle rotation that is applied on top of any other potential rotation, like the stroke rotation. We can also flip the image of the brush in vertical or horizontal by using the tip flip U or tip flip V parameters. Finally, there's the tip orient stroke, which means that at each sample of the brush stroke, the rotation of the stamp will be set so that the actual brush stroke is followed. We can see this clearly by looking at the results of the stroke. Whereas if we disable it, each sample of the brush stroke will be oriented in exactly the same rotation. In the shape dynamics section, we have the size, strength, angle, and position jitters. These jitters add some variation to each brush sample, allowing us to create some nice effects. Please note that these parameters, especially the position jitter, can slow down sculpting as it can potentially generate up to 20 times the amount of bread samples per stroke.